हेलो, वेलकम एवरीवन. माय नेम इज़ हार्दिक गुप्ता. आई एम बेस्ड फ्रॉम देहरादून, इंडिया. आई एम करेंटली परसुइंग माय बैचलर्स इन कंप्यूटर साइंस फ्रॉम ग्राफिक एरा हिल यूनिवर्सिटी. माय मेंटर इज़ बॉबी मस्कारा, एंड द हाइपरलेजर प्रोजेक्ट दैट वी हैव यूज एंड लर्न थ्रू आउट दिस मेंटरशिप वॉज हाइपरलेजर फायरफ्लाई. वी ऑल्सो डिड अ बिट रिसर्च ऑन अदर हाइपरलेजर प्रोजेक्ट्स, बट द मेजॉरिटी ऑफ वर्क वॉज डन इन हाइपरलेजर फायरफ्लाई. So, okay, so I'm starting with the project description. So our purpose was to build a agile and a transparent transparent network between donors, volunteers, and recipient to build a giving chain that will not just help people in like people that are suffering from disaster, but also will bring a change in the whole charity system that has been flawed or that has been misused since a long time. The Giving Chain project was started in 2019 by Bobby in Princeton, and now finally we are running three projects simultaneously. So I will talk about this like further. So the donors can be the farmers, any individual, the community, church groups, or people who want to donate anything. It can be a sweater, it can be food, it can be anything that you want to donate. The volunteers, the drivers, the transporters can be the people who picks up the donation from the donors and then deliver it to recipients. It can be the drivers, can be the local volunteer or from a group, or even we project managers can do this. Finally, the recipients can be the NGOs, can be the food banks, can be people who, like normal individual can also, or NGOs can also request for donations. So the technologies that we have used like is firstly the Hyperledger Firefly. We have built the front end in React. The UI is built in React. And for the back end, we have used a Node and Express.js. So the objectives that we have followed was first to complete and answer all the checkpoints for the social impact blockchain project. These checkpoints were as follows. The first checkpoint was impact opportunities. I'm going to explain all of these in like very quickly. So first, impact opportunities. These the opportunities that our project will make. Secondly, was the business model validation. In this process, we build a business model, we validate it, we check if this model can work. And finally, we move to the next checkpoint, that is checkpoint three, that is a technical architecture. Then we, in this checkpoint, we talk about which technologies we will be using and how we will be using and how it will complement or can make problem for our business model. We then make changes accordingly. And then we finally start with the technical part. Then comes a checkpoint four, that is impact measurement. In this checkpoint, we do dry runs. In this checkpoint, it's not in, like the code is not there. We just do a dry run for our business model. Finally, the checkpoint five and six is all technical work. Here, the code is being developed and it's worked on. And finally, we have a final product. Then the second objective that was to work and improve on the problems that we faced with the Giving Chain 2019. Bobby worked on that project, and like few of the problems that we faced at that time was the IoT project. So the IoT devices that we were using with Hyperledger Sawtooth were very expensive. And finally, the objective three was to scale the project. Our main aim with starting and with building the Giving Chain was to scale as much as possible so that the project can not just be used in a particular disaster or in a particular country, but can be used by any and everyone. Okay, so the deliverables that we have given were like, we had a robust business model. We built it and it is till now very successful. We have done dry runs and it is well created. We are using this like mostly the same business model that Bobby created in 2019. Second was the deliverable was to code and develop an agile and transparent network, the whole coding part. The third one was the documentation, and finally the presentation, the presenting the Giving Chain to both social impact and trade finance special interest groups. And this delivery has been done. So the accomplishments, first, like as I've told, the business model is completed and we have a working prototype. I would like to thank Mona because she helped us and Hyperledger Firefly guys because they helped us like in every possible way for this. Things that we are still have to do are the documentation part and the implementations of NFTs in our project. The thing that I am and like the whole team is most proud of is that we have presented the giving chain to both social impact and the trade finance groups, and we also have collected more than $600 or $700 in our for our Hyperledger India project, and which Madhu is running. And finally, the most challenging thing for us was to move from Hyperledger Sawtooth to Hyperledger Firefly. In this process, we crashed into many Hyperledger meetings. We talked to many people. We had a lot of fun, but yes, it was very challenging part of our project. So the recommendations for future work, like the first point is obviously we have to implement the NFTs to our project. The NFTs will be used for transferring the ownership of the donations. The documentation of the project is still to be done. Implementing the prototype is a very hard task till now, and we want to finish the documentation as soon as possible. Project managers is a very big part of our solution of scaling the project, and we want to open registrations for project managers. Second, abstracting the whole project for project managers so that project managers can focus on the whole charity part. And like the most important thing that we have still that we are still planning on working on is to scale the project and to get the project into Hyperledger Labs. I'm going to give you a brief explanation, and then I will show you the demo, a live prototype. So if any one of you who wants to help us or who wants to work on the giving chain, like the things that you have to do is first get with the Firefly CLI because it's the easiest way of using Firefly, and it is also needed for our project. Secondly, this is the GitHub link for our project. And if you want to just play with the code or even try our prototype, you can just clone it. And with the CLI, you can run it in no time. So we have three projects running simultaneously. Furnace, the one is the project Princeton. This is being done by Bobby. Second one is project Uttarakhand. I am doing this one. It's for people who are suffering from floods. Because Uttarakhand is a hilly part of the northern area or of northern India, which is famous for its holy places and temples and its holy rivers. So in monsoons, most of these rivers overflood, and due to this, many villages have to suffer. So I'm working on this project. Finally, Madhu, our third mentee, working for Project Women India. She wants to help women who are underprivileged and who don't have money to buy sanitary napkins. The fundraising has been done for this project, and if any one of you who wants to donate, the fundraisers are still on. Okay, so I will share the demo just a second. Is my screen visible?
Yes.
Yes, thank you. Okay, so these are the Firefly nodes that are running. Okay, so this is the app. I'm gonna just breeze through it. So for the donors part, if like we will be using NFTs. This part is still not done because NFT token has to be added by Fireflies, and I guess they have done it. So after these meetings, we will be building this part. So if anyone who wants to add a donation, these are the fields that have to be filled for any donor: the name, the last name, the address. So I have auto-filled them, the city, the state, because I will be doing that for my, this is for my state, the zip code, then the email, phone number, finally a description and a image, because this image will be used for creating NFTs. And description can be anything, a cat. I'm not going to donate my cat. I'm just, so like this. Okay, so this says that the thing has been, sorry, the image has been, the donation has been registered, and I'm going to show you all these things that have been created, and okay, data uploaded. So if I go back to my first node and if check, I can see that the message has been uploaded. That if I'm going to check for the data, I can also see that, just Yes. Okay, so the first message has been broadcasted to the whole network. A donation has been created. So any so now what like when the donation is created and finally the message that the donation has been created has been broadcasted to the whole network. Any volunteer in this network can come and say that yes, I want to pick up this donation, and then he will be assigned to get the whole data. So a broadcast is obviously public, so everyone in the network can see, but as my information is to be kept private. So in the next private message is all the all is my location, is my email, my phone number, and the details of the donation. And this private message will only be sent to that volunteer or that transporter who has accepted to pick up my donation. Okay, now when I come here, and it is like I can see all the donations that has been already made or that has or that are ready to picked up. So like now what we are trying to build or what we have to build is a transfer function for transferring these NFTs or these donation. Finally, then comes the NGO part. So what NGOs can do is that they can request for donations. If let's say there is an NGO that is in need for a particular thing, he like that NGO can request donations. And finally, the recipient part, this like these two things are to be worked on. I'm going back to my presentation. Yes. So the things that I've learned and I've gained through this through my mentorship program, firstly, like the first thing that I have to say is that I had fun. I enjoyed the journey. I learned a lot, especially from Bobby. I gained my and I gained and I improved my presentations and management skills, especially my presentation, because like both Bobby and me have been giving presentations throughout the last 6 months. We have worked on both business and the technical aspects of the project. I have learned that technology, like the coding, is not the solution. We have to first think of a like from the business perspective of the whole project. I learned how to work in an open source community and how to get involved, how to talk to people, how to crash into different meetings and ask for help. And finally, this process helped me make many and like I'm very serious because I've made many connections both in my through all the meetings and through my work, and I've learned a lot about many Hyperledger projects. Thank you, and thank you, Bobby, for this opportunity.
Thank you, Hardik. It's just so great to see not only your learning in technical skills, but also just the soft skills, right? How to communicate with others, how do you manage your project, how do you present your project to a bigger audience? So these are all great skills that you can apply to any opportunities for you down the road. So Bobby, do you have anything to add here?
I just want to say that it was an experience that I value. I've learned so much from these guys, both Monares Lu, Madhu Bahati, and Hardik have taught me that these young kids have a lot to offer. And if we can tap into it, we're going to be better off for it. And I just hope that this Giving Chain project grows and grows and becomes something that's available for a global use for disaster relief. And I appreciate all the hard work Hardik did. And again, I thought he'd be coding a lot. And like you said, it was more business end. Coding was like the last piece, but I'm very proud of all the work he did. So congratulations, Hardik. Great job.
Thank you.
Thank you, Bobby, and thank you for the other contributors who also worked on this project as well. So thank you.